Hear in kindness, O Lord, the prayers of your people, that those who rejoice at the coming of your beloved Son in our flesh may, when at last he comes in glory, gain the reward of eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
Reading from the Song of Songs. Hark, my lover, here he comes, springing across the mountains, leaping across the hills. My lover is like a gazelle or a young stag. Here he stands behind our wall, gazing through the windows, peering through the lattices. My lover speaks. He says to me, "Arise, my beloved, my dove, my beautiful one, and come. For see, the winter is past. The rains are over and gone. The flowers appear on the earth. The time of pruning the vines has come. The song of the dove is heard in our land. The fig tree puts forth its figs, and the vines in bloom give forth fragrance. Arise, my beloved, my beautiful one, and come. My dove, in the clefts of the rock, in the secret recesses of the cliff, let me see you. Let me hear your voice, for your voice is sweet and you are lovely." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Exalt you just in the Lord, sing him a new song.
Exalt you just in the Lord, sing him a new song.
Give thanks to the Lord from the heart, with a 10-string lyre, chant his praises. Sing to him a new song, pluck the strings skillfully with shouts of gladness.
Exalt you just in the Lord,
sing to him a new song. But the plan of the Lord stands forever, the design of his heart through all generations. Blessed the nation whose God is the Lord, the people he has chosen for his own inheritance.
Exalt you just in the Lord, sing to him a new song.
Our soul waits for the Lord, who is our help and our shield. For in him all hearts rejoice, in his holy name we trust.
Exalt you just in the Lord, sing to him a new song.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
O Emmanuel, our King and Giver of Law, come to save us, Lord our God.
Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to God.
Mary set out in those days and traveled to the hill country in haste, to a town called Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant leaped in her womb. And Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, "Most blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
The second joyful mystery. Mary blessed Elizabeth. And as we are told, at the moment the sound of Mary's greeting reached Elizabeth's ears, the infant in her womb lived for joy. One characteristic of Christmas is our ability to share the good news of Christ's coming with others. And so during Christmas, you realize that almost all of us, we visit our families, we visit our friends to have good time with them, to have good lunch and time dinner with them, and what have you. These are all beautiful because that's what Mary likes. But Mary also elevates that visit of fraternity to another level. She makes us understand that it is not all about sharing joys, smiling, eating, and what have you. But then, basically, what is so important is about sharing Christ with others, with our family, with our friends, the good news that we have received and continue to receive with those we encounter. So we realize in the gospel that Elizabeth was not merely happy because Mary was present with her, but she was so happy because Mary came with Christ. Mary brought Christ to her home. Mary brought Christ to her unborn child. The good news that we are waiting for, Mary brought it to them. And so we are also encouraged this season of Advent. In a few days, Christ is going to be with us. That when Christ comes, it is good that we visit others, visit our families, our friends, and what have you. But then we should elevate also the visit to a mystical level. Sharing the good news with them, Christ with them, for that is the fullness of joy. The others may bring us joy, but the fullness of joy, joy that will penetrate our material being, as we had in the gospel, it penetrated the material being of Elizabeth for it to even reach John the Baptist in her womb. May we be exalted by this fact. Example of our Mother Mary and share the good news of Christ with whoever we come across this Christmas. God bless us.
Amen.
sent bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, the disciples said, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." Partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Mario, our bishop, and all the family. Remember also our brothers and sisters who are falling asleep in the hope of their resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who are praised through all the ages, we may merit to go as an eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and majesty, forever and ever. Amen. And the Savior's command, informed by his divine teaching, we dare to say,
"Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all the troubles, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, glory, and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her the peace and unity in accordance with your will. You will ever reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. being subject